harmony and discord. For centuries, people have heard the tale of the wandering musician and the children of Hamelin. Every tale has more than one side, so I will tell you a story or two, but from the musician's point of view. Hamelin is a pretty little town. Chase cats. They chew rat poison like bubblegum. How do you get rid of rats? Look, here's an oddly dressed person wearing a patched up cloak and a tattered cap. Perhaps a penniless, wandering musician.
Thank you. Yes? What is it? I'm a busy man.
Do you have work for a traveling musician?
Not unless you can get rid of rats.
Oh, that's my specialty. What will you pay?
A penny a rat.
No, 10 cents.
2 cents. 10 cents. 3 cents. 10 cents, cash on delivery.
Filled with curiosity, the villagers leaned out of their windows and watched while the two haggled and bargained. So, for the price of 10 cents per eliminated rat, the contract was signed. The stranger polished his instrument lovingly and played a little swirl of notes. All the town's rats twitched their whiskers angrily. They faced each other, the rats and the musician. The rats advanced, gnashing their teeth, and the musicians rained on them like drops of boiling oil. The rats retreated, then attacked again. The musicians hurled crescendos at them, attacked them with arpeggios, and shot them with hundreds of staccati. Each knew it was a battle to the death. Like a banner of triumph, and the mayor's children followed after the crowd and beat valiantly on a shiny pink drum.
Hey,
and told the musician that a municipal park was to be named in his honor. Brian Park. Complete the golf course. The hero said modestly that he had just done his duty as he saw it. And now, since he had gone to being, since he had to be going, if they would just settle up the bill.
The mayor talked some more of honor and glory.
The musician said, happy to be in a service, now about the fee.
This illustrious deed will be ever cherished in our hearts.
The musician mentioned, money, money, money. The villagers muttered, how crass, how insensitive, and said, the rats weren't really very bad. There had only been a few, two or three, very small ones at that. People don't mind what they charge these days, do they? And the villagers looked down their noses at the strangers. The musician said, you promised to pay exactly this amount, you know. But the townspeople just laughed and went into their houses and slammed the door. When he realized he'd been cheated, the musician flew into a terrible tantrum. Rats are not the only thing I can lure away. Then, as the first magic notes of the stranger's new tune began to float upon the air, the doors of the houses slowly swung open, and all the children of Hamelin followed the rainbow of sound as the musician led them away. is now a quiet town. The musician is gone, and so are the children. No one really knows what happened to those children. Some say they were never heard from again, but others say that on one day of each year, if you listen carefully, you can hear the sound of children's voices singing in the distance. That's all of the story of Hamelin. Of course, the musician still roams the earth, meeting new people. He plays for them all, and you'll know he's come to your town when you hear this merry tune.